In the early stages of catching the Streptococcus bacteria, the number B of bacteria present in a sick throat after T minutes can be modeled by B equals B sub 0 times E to the 0.007 T, where B sub 0 is the initial number of bacteria present. How long will it take for the number of bacteria to triple? Well, not a fun example, but very interesting, actually. Bacteria grows very quickly in the body. So we have B as the number of bacteria. B sub 0 is the initial number. T is the time in minutes. All right, real quickly. T is time in minutes. So that is what we're solving for. So that's why I made a big deal of making sure we know what that variable is. Okay, to triple. So we want to know how long will it take for B to equal 3 times B sub 0. How long will it take for that to happen? Okay, so when I write out this formula, I'm not going to write B, I'm going to write 3 times B sub 0. So we have 3 times B sub 0 equals B sub 0 times E to the 0.007 T. Now we can divide everything by B sub 0. That's just a multiplier, and we're left with then 3 equals E to the 0.007 T. I left a little space there because what we're going to be doing there is we're going to take the natural log of each side. If this side equals the other side, we can take the natural log of each side. By the way, you could also do this with the log base 10, but we'll see why it works out a lot better to take the natural log. The natural log is a log base E. All right, so we have a log base 3, or I'm sorry, natural log of 3. So natural log of 3 equals, here's a property of logarithms. When we have the logarithm of something raised to an exponent, we can take that exponent and move it out to the front. So we have then 0.007 times t multiplied by the natural log of e. Okay, a little sidebar here. The natural log of e, that equals log base e of e, and there's a property that says log base b of b equals 1. But also think about this. E raised to what power would equal e? Well, that is 1, so we have 1. And that's actually the reason why we do this natural log. It makes it a little easier, and then you kind of get in the habit, and when you're solving for exponents later on, you'll keep on taking the natural log. So this crosses out, little notation to say 1. So that means that we have 0.007 times t equals natural log of 3. Okay, you can leave this as natural log of 3, or you could type that into your calculator. Either way, it's okay at this point. I am going to just show this, just to show that if you do take the logarithm or do some evaluation before the problem is finished, it's a very good habit to hang on to a lot of decimal places, at least that many, because you don't want to round until the end. Okay, so this is natural log of 3 is 1.098612. That's just gotten by plugging that into the calculator. Now we're going to divide each side by this coefficient, by 0.007. And I am going to put t, write this as t first. T equals, the number is 157. We know that it's in minutes. And oh, 157, but that's just in minutes. So actually, it'll only take about 2 hours and 37 minutes for the number of bacteria to triple. Now, the problem is finished. We've solved for the exponent, but just a couple of notes there. That's pretty real. This is just an example, and it differs by person and how their immune system is and all that stuff. But yeah, the bacteria do grow very quickly.